MediatR is a NuGet package, which is a implementation of the MediatR design pattern. And MediatR design pattern supports communication between two objects. The NuGet package MediatR is mainly used for in-process messaging between multiple components with no dependencies. It supports request response, command queries, and notifications and event patterns, both synchronous and asynchronously. Now, when we get into some of the implementation, there are subtle differences between each type of the events. So let's get started. We are going to start with request response, and then we are going to talk about notification. So before we do anything, first thing you have to do is we have to install the NuGet package. And I'm going to go ahead and go to the package manager, and I'm going to install here. So MediatR is the NuGet package, and you can see it has 122 million downloads. It's pretty popular. It has dependency on .NET Standard 2.0 and .NET 6. So if you're using any version of .NET, it should work, because .NET Standard 2.0 works with all versions of .NET Core as well as legacy .NET. And if you're using .NET 6 and onwards, it's going to use this dependency. So I'm just going to install this. And I am using right now .NET 7 as the version of .NET. So after we install this, first thing we need to do is add the MediatR to our dependency. So for that, what we can do is we can say here, builder.services.addMediatR. And it takes a configuration action. So I can just take the configuration. And then we can register from assemblies, register services from assembly, register service from assembly containing a particular class. So what we can do is we can just register services from assembly containing, and for the class, we can just give program, which is the current class. And that's about it. So it's going to register every classes that are part of this particular project. But apart from just registering assembly, there are a few other configuration. For example, type evaluator. It's an optional filter of types to register. So we can use that to filter out certain type. Then we have notification publisher type, which is again the type of notification publisher strategy to register. Again, these are some of the things we'll probably never use. Just leave it to default behaviors. Most of the time, we are going to just use register from assembly containing a type. So now that the registration is over, what we can do is we can create certain classes which are going to talk to each other. So first, let's define a request. So for defining a request, what we can do is we just create a new class, and we can name it as weather message, let's say. And this class is going to implement an interface called iRequest, which is part of the MediatR namespace. And you can see iRequest has both generic as well as non-generic implementation. So we're just going to use the generic implementation. And for here, we're going to use the weather forecast as the type. And that pretty much it. That's our message object. And then what we can do is we can create a handler. So here, can come and we can say weather message handler. And for this class, what we can do is we can implement the interface iRequestHandler, which is the class which will be responsible for handling a request, basically handling a message. We are going to implement the interface iRequestHandler. And for the iRequestHandler, the incoming message for us is going to be the weather message. And then you can see the iRequestHandler has two overload. One is just incoming, the first one, where we are just handling the message and we're not going to return anything. The other overload takes a request in and a response. So we are going to use the request response model, and the response has to be the same response object that we are passing here as a part of iRequest. So here it is going to be weather forecast. Now we have to implement the interface. So let's implement the interface here. And at this point, what we can do is we can first go to this implementation of weather forecast creation, which is here. And this is where we are returning the weather forecast. Now, weather forecast here is an enumerable. So let's just change it to just a single one so that we can match our method. And for the time being, it's just going to be empty. We'll come back and fix this. And here, what we can do is, instead of enumerable of multiple, we just return one weather, and we just have to also have summaries, which needs to go here. So we have summaries, and for the index, we can just say add days of one should be good enough. And then that's pretty much it. And then here, because it is a task, what we need to do is we need to do task.fromResult and then put it inside of this. That's pretty much what we need to do. So now the request handler is based on request. Right now we are not checking what kind of request it is getting. We are just, as soon as we get a request, we are just returning a response, which is of type weather forecast. Now what we are going to do is, now this is where we need to use the mediator to send a request and get the response. So for that, what we can do is we can add here iMediator and then declare the mediator. Let's keep names as underscore, just like the logger. And then here, what we can do is we can say var response is equal to underscore mediator dot send. And here we can send the request. And for us, it is nothing but just new of weather forecast, weather message, because that is our request object, which is the weather message. And once we get the response, we can just return, and you can see the response is of type weather forecast. It can be null, so just make it as null, and we can just return the response here. And here I'm just going to make it as task, because it's to be a task. And that's pretty much it. So now what we are doing is, when we call a get, we're going to send a message through mediator with the weather message, which is then going to be handled by this message handler, which is going to create this object and return. So we can put a breakpoint here just to show that this is working. And let's just run in standard HTTPS. And once it is started, we can try it out from the swagger. And here we can see, as soon as we clicked on that method, this mediator.send is triggered. It is coming here in the handle. and the handle is going to return a response, and then we're going to return it back to the UI. And you can see we got a date, temperature in centigrade and Fahrenheit, and a summary. So this is a very simple implementation of mediator design pattern using the mediator library. And as you can see, it is extremely, extremely easy to start with this library. It literally just added this dependency to the dependency injection container. Then to the controller, we can inject mediator and then just send a message. And then on the other side, we wrote the message object itself, which decides what kind of output this message object ultimately is going to return through the message handler. And here we wrote the message handler, which takes this message and returns this object that we defined here through the request handler, where we are saying this is the message and this is the response. And here we are just creating the weather object and returning. So this is just an introduction to mediator. In my next video, I'm going to talk about some of the other implementation, for example, using one-way mechanism of handling messages. And then I'm going to explore how to use the notification use case using mediator. So that is all I wanted to cover for today's video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you are new to this channel and you think you are getting value out of this channel, please subscribe to the channel. And thanks so much for watching this video.